Sadanto suche toye alahati samyao sambudoche. Namo sadanto suche toye alahati samyao sambudoche. Namo sadanto suche toye alahati samyao sambudoche.
Wu sang shen shen wei miao fa, bai qian wan jie nan zao yu, wo jin jian wen de shou shi, 愿解如来真实义. The
unsurpassed, deep, profound, subtle, wonderful Dharma in 100,000 million eons is difficult to encounter. Now that I've come to receive and hold it within my sight and hearing, I vow to fathom the thus come one's true and actual meaning.
诸佛菩萨、圣公上人以及还有我们在座的善知识，大家晚安。我们今天晚上继续来研究《无量寿经》。
All Buddhas and Bodhisattvas, Venerable Master, all Dharma Masters and fellow cultivators, Amitabha. Tonight we will be continuing to investigate the Sutra on Limitless Life.
So today
we are studying the Sutra on Limitless Life. We should have a sutra text before you. And we are coming here at Berkeley Buddhist Monastery, October 1st, 2016, to study this sutra.
我们还是一样的，我们要念七遍莲池海会和菩萨来跟我们一起来，跟大家共修以及跟我们加持。So
we hope to invoke the names of the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. It's on the front of your sheet. 南无莲池海会佛菩萨. So invoke the Bodhisattvas, Buddhas and Bodhisattvas names 7 times. And invite them to come and bless us and cultivate here with us. Namo Lien Chi Hai Hui Ho Bu Sa Namo Lien
namo genji ai wei ho bu dai namo genji ai wei ho bu dai namo genji ai wei ho bu我们上次已经讲完了这个三十一位的阿罗汉大阿罗汉今天讲完第一位就是正业廖本济教成主尊者那我们今天就研究第二位正业
So last week, our last time we investigated the sutras, we were going over the 31 venerable arhats listed in the beginning of the sutra on page 1. And we went over the first one, the venerable realizing the ultimate origin. Today we will be reading and discussing the second one, venerable right vows, Ashvajit. He was also one of the first five disciples of the Buddha.
我看我们还是读一下经文，把这个31位我们读完，然后也念一遍英文，这样子。So
we could recite the sutra together. We can recite the 31 names together in Chinese and English, just so that we get the sounds in the air.
好，我们大家一起念哦。
So read it together.
好，从哪里开始？ Yeah, 我们从最上面开始。佛说无量寿经。
Start very top.
Yeah, 佛说无量寿经，我闻之是，一时佛住王首城，其舍劫三中，以大比丘众，万二千人聚。 一切大圣神通已达，其名曰尊者廖本济，尊者正愿，尊者正义，尊者大号，尊者仁贤，尊者离垢，尊者明文，尊者善识，尊者具足，尊者牛王。 尊者优罗频罗迦瑟，尊者迦耶迦瑟，尊者拿提迦瑟，尊者摩诃迦瑟，尊者舍利弗，尊者大目犍连，尊者揭宾那，尊者大住，尊者大净智，尊者摩诃周那。 尊者满愿直，尊者离藏，尊者流贯，尊者坚弗，尊者面王，尊者义臣，尊者仁性，尊者迦勒，尊者善来，尊者罗云，尊者阿难，皆如是等上首者也。 好, 英文.
We recite the English. So we will, I think if we recite the names of the sutra, we'll skip the sections in parentheses. We'll just read the section in English that's not in parentheses. So we'll start from the very top. Okay. Sutra of the Buddha's teachings on infinite life. Thus I have heard. At one time, the Buddha was staying in Vulture Peak Mountain, in the capital city of Magadha, together with 12,000 great bhikshus. All were great sages who have already attained spiritual powers. Their names are Venerable Realizing the Ultimate Origin, Venerable Right Vows, Venerable Right Speech, Venerable Great Name, Venerable Benevolent Goodness, Venerable Free of Defilement, Venerable Renown, Venerable Reliable Goodness, Venerable Completeness, Venerable Lord of Cow, Venerable Rubila, let's say it again. Venerable Rubila Bilvakashyapena, Venerable Gaya Kashyapa, Venerable Nadi Kashyapa, Venerable Maha Kashyapa, Venerable Shariputra, Venerable Mahamagagyana, Venerable Kapina, Venerable Great Existing, Venerable Great Pure Aspiration, Venerable Mahachunda, Venerable Sum of Complete in Vows, Venerable Free of Obstruction, Venerable River, Venerable Mighty Conqueror, Venerable King of Perfect Appearance, Venerable Extraordinary Vehicle, Venerable Kind-Hearted, Venerable Joy and Happiness, Venerable Welcome, Venerable Rahula, and Venerable Ananda. All of them were leaders among the assembly.
阿巴吉阿巴吉就是阿修士他用这个音翻过来巴利文也是一样阿沙吉那中文就是阿斯婆或者是阿斯婆
So the first or the bhikshu we're talking about right now is Venerable Right Vows. His Sanskrit name is Ashvajit, and so the Chinese often translated his name as Ma Ling Bicho.
Ma Sen.
Ma Sen Bicho. Ma Si horse. So yeah. Ma, yeah. Yeah, because I believe the word Ashva means horse. So he is Ashvajit. So they translate his horse. And this was the common translation during the Tang Dynasty.
So 就是阿含经因为我们翻译啊有从阿含经就是小乘的然后我们大乘里面翻译的我们大乘的大部分都是用它的意思翻出来所以也有用它的音译翻过来所以这个翻译的名字有时候 也很多名字出现，但是你我们只要去认真的去看它，或者研究它，就可以知道。
So studying the various Buddhist teachers and masters from the past isn't easy because there's so many names. They get both translated by meaning. Oftentimes, that's the way it gets translated, as well as transliteration. So they end up having multiple names. So what for us to do is studying them is just to be sincere and pay attention and we will be able to learn the different ways we refer to them.
So this Ma Sheng Bi Qiu 第四天他就开了这个法眼镜
So this venerable Ashvajit, he was the youngest of the five monks that the Buddha taught at Deer Park when he after he woke up. And so after the Buddha taught the Four Noble Truths, venerable Ashvajit realized you could say arhatship on the fourth day after the Four Noble Truths teaching.
This 开始证到圣地了。他是五比丘算最后证果的人。
So actually, he didn't realize full arhatship. He realized the first fruit of arhatship. You could say they usually say he opened his dharma eye. He opened the dharma vision, and that means he got a first glimpse of the dharma, and he enters into the stream of the dharma. So oftentimes, the first fruit or the first stage of arhatship is also called a stream enterer or a stream winner, because they enter the stream of the dharma. Among the five bhikshus, he was the last one to get awakened.
所以当时那个在鹿野宴的时候，因为那时候还没有两位比丘还没有就是马胜跟摩诃南，后面我会介绍到他，因为他没有开悟，所以他就留在没有出去托钵，就留在鹿野宴。然后这个其他的三位比丘出去托钵，托钵回来就是加上佛陀一起，总共六个，就是三个人去托钵，六个人回来一起吃饭。所以这个就是这个还有马胜比丘，在他托钵回来以后，他听闻这个无我相经以后，他就得到阿罗汉果。
你是刚刚说他们去托钵时候，那个正院尊者他留在那边吗？没有托钵，
对，没有托，因为他没有开悟，所以
跟两个别的地球也在那边留在那边，三个尊者，
那么两个跟佛陀，就是
佛陀也留下来。
对，就是应该教导他们，
okay,
因为他两个没有
okay,
没有开悟
okay,
所以留下来，所以那外面还有就是五个嘛，那其他三个就出去托钵，托钵就是回来给六个人吃这样子。
So because he hasn't woken up, him and another monk, venerable great name, which you see later in the list, Mahanama, great name, since they didn't wake up, they stayed at Deer Park with the Buddha, and the Buddha taught them, as even during the alms round. So the alms round, the other three monks, so there's five monks, so two monks stayed behind with the Buddha, and three monks went off for alms round, and they got some food, and they brought it back, and the six monks would all share the food together. Later, after the Buddha spoke on the Anattalakkhana Sutta, which is the sutra on no self, or not self, venerable right vows or venerable ashvajit, he woke up. He became a four stage arhat.
所以这个像无相无我相经就是说无我相，无我相这个也是在我们修行也是很重要的，所以上人也常常说我们修行要少四相。找四相就是人相、我相，刚才讲的这个无我相经，然后就还有众生相，还有就是寿者相，总共四相。我们修行能够少四相，这个就是能够得到清净，然后依法相应。所以这个我们上人一直在鼓励我们修行，就是要少四相。
So this sutra.Or is called the Sutra of having no mark of self. And so Venerable Master would often teach that we should not have any marks, you could say, any kind of attachments to the conceptualizations of a self. And so we should wipe these clean, we should sweep these clean. We shouldn't have a mark of self, a mark of others, a mark of living beings, or a mark of lifespans. We want to sweep these all clean.
所以他得了这个正果以后就是有一天马胜比丘他出去乞食，托钵走在路上，然后那时候给了外道，那时候刚开始舍利弗还没有真正学习佛法，他学习外道， 他看到马生比丘他所走路的动作举止都非常的端好，非常的殊胜，所以这个他就问马生比丘，就停下来就跟他询问他。
So after Venerable Ashvajit realized Buddhahood, or realized Arhatship, he went out of alms round. And when he was going on alms round, he was walking on the road. And another member of another religion, and this at this time was Shariputra actually, but at that time he wasn't a Buddhist disciple, but was a follower of another religion, of you could say an externalist sect. And so he saw Venerable Ashvajit walking very mindfully on the road with very good deportment. And so he walked up to very respectfully to Venerable Ashvajit and asked him some questions on the Dharma.
所以他就问马生比丘说你的老师是什么人，你在学习什么法。
So he asked, who is your teacher? What Dharma are you studying?
马生比丘他就跟他讲诸法从缘生，诸法从缘灭，我佛大沙门常作如是说。
So all the conditions that arises, so 诸法，
就是说所有的我们一切的法都是从因缘里面生出来，然后也从因为这个因缘里面灭。然后我佛大沙门就是我的老师释迦牟尼佛的这个大沙门，他常常这样子来教导我们。
Okay, so it says all conditions arise because everything arises because of conditions, and everything ceases because of conditions. All conditioned dharmas arise from conditions, all conditioned dharmas cease from conditions. This is the teaching of my teacher Shakyamuni Buddha. He often speaks like this.
所以他这个讲完了，听完了以后，舍利弗当时他也是得了法眼镜，法眼镜就是悉陀梵国，就是刚才讲的一流国，这个就是入圣人流。
So at this point, Shariputra he also realized the first stage of arhatship when he heard this teaching. He Venerable Ashvajit in the very beginning, he attained the Dharma eye and entered the stream of the Dharma, became a stream enterer.
这个读这个悉陀梵谷，他就是可以还要来人间七次，七次以后他就可以证果解脱。
So, a stream enterer, a first stage arhat.Their realization is such that they will need to come back to, they only have to come back to samsara, into this world, seven more times. They have seven more rebirths before they realize arhatship.
那这个舍利弗他听到了这个以后，他因为他那时候舍利弗跟目犍连两个好朋友，所以他就赶快回去跟他的好朋友目犍连说我找到了修行的真理的真正信赖的人，所以舍利弗跟目犍连他就放弃了他外道的这个修行法，然后就去亲近佛陀的真团修行。
So Venerable Shariputra had his good friend named Venerable Mahamoggallana, so he went back to Venerable Mahamoggallana and told himI found a good teacher. Let's both go and study under him. And so both Venerable Shariputra and Venerable Mahamoggallana went to study under the Buddha. So later their names come up as well on this list. You'll see about halfway down the page, Venerable Shariputra and Venerable Mahamoggallana.
那舍利弗他进入真团以后的第七天，他就证到阿罗汉果了。
So,For Venerable Shariputra, after 7 days of cultivation with the Sangha, he realized arhatship.
所以在法际经里面呢，就有说这个舍利弗他就是因为马生比丘他 他看到他的因缘，所以舍利弗能够进入真团，然后正果，然后心里就常常记着这位马胜比丘，像恩师一样，非常的尊敬他，甚至于他睡觉的时候，他的头都要向着这个马胜比丘的方向。
So, Venerable Shariputra was extremely grateful to Venerable Ashvajit for leading him onto the path. So after 7 days in the Sangha cultivating, he became an arhat. And he was so grateful and so respectful to Venerable Ashvajit that when he slept, he would actually sleep with his head in the direction of Venerable Ashvajit.
所以这个舍利弗，因为他这个动作啊，他这个朝睡觉朝向这个马胜比丘的方向，这个动作就引起了这个其他的比丘说他还是在学习外道法，他还没有学习释迦牟尼的。但是这个事情也后来也释迦牟尼佛也知道了。
So other monks actually criticized Venerable Shariputra, saying, Venerable Shariputra is still cultivating externalist dharmas. He's not truly practicing the Buddha's dharma. And so this, practice that Venerable Shariputra was doing also became known to the Buddha.
那这个佛陀就跟所有的比丘讲比丘们，舍利弗并不是他在礼敬四方，因为他们学习那时候是外道是礼敬四方，他说不是在礼敬四方，而是在尊敬他的引导他亲近这个佛教的老师马胜比丘，这样的恭敬老师是对的。
So the Buddha told the monks, he says, all you bhikshus,Venerable Shariputra is not worshipping the four directions, because the externalists would often worship the four directions as a practice. So the Buddha told them, he's not worshipping the four directions. Instead, he is paying respect to his teacher, the one who led him into the Sangha, and so he is very grateful. So this practice of respect is a correct one, is a wholesome one.
另外就是在记这里经典上也有记载，马胜比丘他是六群比丘之一。
六群？
六群比丘，六群。
六群是？
就是群，一群的群。
Six group, the group of six.
Yeah.
是，但是六群是比丘做很多不对的事情。
对对，犯戒的。
So, also Venerable Ashvajit was part of the, you sometimes say call him the gang of six.In the Vinaya, who ended up breaking a lot of precepts, and the Buddha set up the precepts. So, how is Alo Han Fan Jie?
是这样子。我们有时候是看事情，他是在视线的，所以这个是讲再来视线的。
So, we think that perhaps he's, well, he came back and he was actually the.A lot of the senior, kind of the great arhats, they came back and they manifested breaking the precepts while in their hearts truly not breaking it. But this allowed the Buddha to be able to establish the precepts to teach later generations.
所以我们看经典，看这个圣人，他们有时候因为也有一些犯戒的，所以佛陀才会记录这些，就是等于跟我们一样的，给的做法，就是要给我们有这样子的一个示范。不是他并不是真正那个，后面我们还会再提到。
So these great disciples of the past, they were manifesting, you know, breaking the precepts in order to establish a framework and a structure for us to cultivate in the future.It isn't that they truly were kind of in their hearts breaking the precepts. So this will be discussed later.
所以他的犯戒是这样子，他在守卫国的一个村庄里面，自己去种花种木，然后自己做花幔送给 别人，这个就是送给在家人。
So he, at one point was, you could say, growing flowers and gathering wood. 他在
种，就是种花木啦，就是。
花木 ，so just kind of he was planting and growing some flowers and small trees. And he was taking the what was grown and giving it to lay people.
他种花，做花蔓。
做花蔓啊。Oh, garland? Garland. Oh, he made a garland of flowers and he would give it to lay people.
Yeah. 因为这样子的行为啊，就是说很容易引起别人的想法哦，他有给他，他没给得到，所以就是会打人家的妄想，哎，就是一种污染的法，就是污染他人的这个妄想，所以当时就佛陀就呵斥他，哎，不要这样子做。
So.At that time, because he did this, he would give these garlands to the various lay people, then people would start having false thinking. They start comparing and saying, he got a garland and I didn't get a garland. And so people are people. And they started having a lot of bickering and false thinking about it. And so the Buddha, you could say, corrected him and said, don't act in this way. Don't do these kind of things.
So he said, 他永不再犯这个事情。
So he made a vow to never do that again.
所以后来他又发愿了，他发愿了去劝当时的大户长者建造60个大的房间来捐给僧团。所以他发这个都是正愿，所以我们就讲他是他叫他是正愿啊。
So later he also 他是跟一个谁叫做一个
大户长者，就是大户长者，就是有钱的。
So he went to a lay person named 大户 like maybe great Dharma protector, a great Dharma protector elder, and worked together to create 60 big you could say buildings for the sangha, these kind of residences for the sangha to cultivate in.And so he made that vow. And so because he made all these proper vows or right vows, another name that he was given was right vows. We have venerable right vows.
So, 马上比丘就是正愿，遵着正愿。那刚才讲的，像他的威仪很好，在圣宫上人也是。常常要我们不管是出家或者在家，像我们在行住坐卧都是要能够非常的庄严，像行如风，立如松，坐如钟，卧如弓。
So, Venerable Ashvajit had very good deportment.Master Hua would often teach us, both monastics and lay, that having good deportment was very important. And so he would often teach that when we walk, we should be like a gentle breeze. When we sit, we should sit like a bell. When we stand, we should stand like a pine tree. And when we lie down, we should recline like a bow, like a drawn bow.
因为我们像走路的时候像风一样的一个是非常安逸轻轻的安逸走，然后这个立就是要像松一样的能够站得很稳固的这样子，然后坐如像钟呢，就是说钟它是一种非常直的直很尖红的这样子，然后卧如弓呢，因为你这样子的睡法能够很安详。
So, the first one is you walk like a breeze. So when you walk, you're like a gentle breeze that's very peaceful and pleasant. The second is standing. So you should stand like a pine tree, very straight and proper. You don't lean to the side. And when you're sitting, you sit like a bell. So a bell is very firm and stable. And so as you sit, you're really, really solid and grounded. And when you lie down like a bow, this is a very helpful posture for sleeping very peacefully and happily.
所以就是星空上人他一直要我们来学习这个算是我们佛教的一个象征代表。
And so these four postures are very helpful because they allow us to be mindful throughout the day of our body. And this is a very, you could say, fundamental practice to help establish
就正法代表，还是正什么？在我们的佛教的一个象征代表。象征呢？嗯，象征。就是一个啊。Like
the real? It's something that you could say is maybe a mark of a truth. You could say it's a kind of very a proper way to do things.
嗯，可以。好，我们这个马胜比丘的，我们就讲到这里。后面我们讲在下面一位第三位就是尊者正语。So the next disciple is
Venerable Right Speech. Vashpa.
他这个正语就是离婆多尊者，离婆多。So
right speech, Venerable Right Speech is, I think, 离婆多's Vashpa. Revata?
Yeah.
Revata. Also another name I think is Revata.
在真阿含经里面呢，离婆多他是坐禅第一。
We have Revata on the bottom as well. Well, Venerable Revata or Vashpa, he was the best at sitting in Chan.
他坐禅的时候，他入定出禅呢，都是心不错乱，所以那时候也有人叫他是离耶比丘，这个耶啊，就是。 孔子耶啊，孟子耶啊，这个耶就是他不用讲话，不讲话的这个样子，离耶比丘。So,
this venerable was the best in Dhyana practice or Chan practice. So the word Dhyana, when it went to China, became Chan. So he was able to enter the Dhyanas and leave Dhyanas completely in a very orderly fashion. There was no scatteredness at all. And so because he was so good at it, the disciples would call him venerable, free of speech, free of words, because he was, you know, in the dhyanas.
这个离婆多这个名字呢，是星首，就是28星首的一个星首的名，四首的名字，星首中他的四就是。 办公室啊，或者是董事长室啊，这个四首的名字。四首的名字。四，就是教室的四。哦，所以他这个是一个28首的一个名字。28。哦，
constellations.
28首就是天上。Constellations.
So and the, okay, his name is one of that. You could say the. I think how they call us the houses. There's these various in the constellations in the sky. When we look in the sky, there's various places in the sky, and you almost call them different houses, different areas in the sky. So his name is one of the houses of those constellations.
这个名字就是从这个星首来的。然后他当初他后母亲就是祈求这个在那里求像28星首里面。
So the reason he got this name is because his mother and father went to worship and request from one of these, you could say, houses of the constellations to have a son. And so they had a son, and so they named their son after this constellation.
这个四首，它是在北方的这个玄武的星首里面。 北方星，因为这个星宿有东西南北，它在北方的 贤五星手里面。
So I'm sorry, I'm not very up with my Indian astrology, but this is, I think, in the more northern part of the sky. So if people want to go out and take a look, I'm sure if you went to look up Indian astrology, you can see all the different ways they map out the sky.
所以迪波多他很喜欢打坐。那有一天呢，他到外面外地去，然后天黑了，他就坐在一个房子里面打坐。
So Venerable Revata or Venerable Right Speech, he really liked to meditate. So one day he went out and the day got dark, and he 他在哪里打坐？他在
一个空屋里面。
空屋 ，he was meditating in a cave.
叫房子了，房
子。No, a kind of empty house. He meditated in an empty house.
然后他打坐的时候就碰到两个鬼在蒸这个尸体。死人的尸体，所以要请他作证，然后他很公正的、很诚实的说，他没有打妄语，所以叫做正语。他的名字就是正语。
So, and he was in this house. So this is actually a haunted house. So there was two ghosts in the house, and they were fighting over a corpse. They both wanted this corpse in this house, and they asked Venerable Right Speech.To be the judge, to tell them, you know, who gets what. And because his speech was so proper, you know, he didn't speak any lies. So he also got the name Right Speech.
所以他打坐的时候，这个就是看到一个鬼啊，就是背着一个尸体来，那后面又跟着一个鬼过来。
So the story goes,he was meditating in this haunted house, and so one ghost came carrying a corpse, you know, dragging a corpse with him, and the other ghost was following behind.
他后面那这个后面来的就是要蒸这个尸体来吃，但是这个背的人啊，就背的那个鬼啊，就不给他。
So the one ghost following behind.Really wanted to, you could say, sue the other monk to get the body. He wanted to eat the corpse. That was his food. And the other monk, though, or the other ghost, wouldn't give it up. He wouldn't give up the corpse. So they were fighting.
因为那个不给他吃，他就去把那个尼波多的这个手就搬下来吃了。
李波多的手啊，
对对，
那个第二个鬼啊，
对对，后面要吃那个。
So, so what happened was this other ghost, the one behind who wanted to eat the corpse, actually grabbed Venerable Rivata's hand and ripped it off and ate his hand.
然后那个背的鬼看到这个很可怜，又赶快就把那个尸体的那个手又把它。搬下来以后就把它放在迪波多的这个手上。
So the other ghost who saw this happen thought this was really too much, and so he took the hand off the other corpse, the corpse that he was carrying, and he put that core hand onto Venerable Revata so that he could kind of another hand.
然后那个吃熟的鬼以后又把他的脚把他搬把他摘下来然后又吃他的脚
This is quite a graphic story. So the other ghost, the second ghost wasn't a very good ghost, went and actually grabbed the leg of the Venerable Rivata and broke it and ate his leg.
那个背尸的鬼又赶快把他尸体上的这个脚的那个尸体的又把它弄脚把它搬下来然后就接那个尼波多的这个脚把它接回去就完好如初
So the first ghost saw this happen as well and so he took the leg off the corpse and he put it onto Venerable Rivata so that the leg he had a leg another leg and so it was as good as new
所以这个后来他这个尼波多他就打坐完了一看一下屋子里面空空的也没有鬼也没有尸体 但是我的身体还在啊。
So then Venerable Rivatta came out of meditation. He looked around. He said, "There's no ghost here. There's no corpse here." And I look at my body. My body is still whole and complete. Everything is, nothing's here.
所以他就一直啊。也怀疑，我百思不解的，一直怀疑这个问题，说我的四肢是不是被鬼吃了？这样子一直在到处问人家。
So he had a doubt in his mind. He didn't know if this was real or not. So he had this question in his heart. He asked many different people, "Did my hand and my leg get eaten by a ghost?"
所以他就一直问，最后问到佛陀那里去了，然后佛陀就跟他开始。
So he asked many, many different people, and finally he asked the Buddha. So the Buddha gave him a Dharma talk.
佛陀跟他讲四大假合，五蕴空花。四大假合就是说我们身体都是由四大地水火风。是合起来，这个都是不是真正的。然后五蕴，我们的眼耳鼻，这些都是不是真正，都是好像空中的花一样，就是不是真实的。
就五蕴吗？就是
五蕴，
色受想行识。
Yeah.
五蕴。Okay. So the Buddha gave him a talk, explained the principles to him. He told Venerable Rivatta, the four elements.Make up the body, earth, fire, water, and air. These four elements are come together into our body, but in the end, they don't last or stay put. They come apart, so they're not real, nothing to rely on. The five skandhas, form, feeling, cognition, formation, and consciousness, these five skandhas that we take to be us also are actually justEmpty, you could say, illusory flowers in the sky. If we were to kind of close our eyes and push our eyeball and then see flowers in the sky from the pressure on our eye, those flowers aren't real. They're just made up from our kind of confusion. And so that's what the five skandhas are like. So Buddha gave him a Dharma talk.
然后他后来他听了以后他就有所悟了。这个悟也是等于他已经有得到真谛，然后他后来他就随这个佛陀出家，然后不久他就证了四果阿罗汉。
So after he heard this talk from the Buddha, he had a, you could say, an awakening, and he understood this truth. And so at that point, he decided to leave home with the Buddha. He asked to leave home with the Buddha and became a monk. And not long after,He realized arhatship.
像这个故事，上人在另外一个地方，他也有这样子讲尼波多的一个不同的讲话。
So in another place, Master Hua told a story about Venerable Rivatta.
其实大部分都是一样，就是讲我们这个身体的。他是说他一直去问人家。跑来说、哦、我这个身体还有没有啊？我的这个是真的、啊、是假的啊？问来问去，问到两个和尚。
So the story Master Hua tells is slightly different, but the principle is the same. So Venerable Rivatta, he would go around and ask people, "Is this body of mine? Is it real or is it false?" And he finally came to two monks. He asked this question to two monks.
那这个两个和尚啊，就是正果的人，他一看哦，这个人啊，他是现在因缘成熟了，所以他很快会证到无我法身。
So the two monks were actually both arhats, and so they examined this person coming to ask this question from them, and they saw that his causes and conditions were ripe.Namely, his potential to wake up was quite nearly there. And so if they just taught him a little bit, he would wake up and realize the principle of not self and the Dharma body.
所以就跟他就跟他说啊、我们这个身体啊本来是因缘和合而成，也因缘和合而灭，没有一个是你，也没有一个不是你。
So they told him, this body of ours comes into being from causes and conditions and ceases because of causes and conditions. Among these conditions, there is nothing that you can say is me or I. You can call yourself.
所以、他一听了以后他就、有所悟，然后他就出家，然后就证果。
So after he heard this teaching, he had an awakening and then decided to leave home and later realized arhatship.
所以这个离婆多呢、他又叫做、尊者正语，又所以刚才就是讲我们的正语，然后又叫做假和合。
So he has many other names as well then. His one name is 正语 or right speech. The other one is 假和合。You could say the illusoriness of causes and conditions. So he has multiple names.
所以、在仙宫上人、对于这个他也有另外一个讲，就是说他因为心正、不颠倒、心定不散乱，所以他是、无捣乱第一，他就是无颠倒第一。
So Venerable Master also said that because his mind was very straight and proper, is very straightforward, a straightforward mind, he was not upside down in any way. He was not, you know, taking things upside down and backwards. He also, his mind was because it was constantly focused, he was not scattered in any way. And so therefore, he also had the name of being the most, 就是正，就正什么第一？
不散乱。
不散乱。Okay, be not being scattered first or foremost, and not being scattered.
无颠倒，颠倒散乱。
And not being upside down or backwards.
Yeah. 还有善人，你大家看他也有啊、赞颂语句，称赞他。他说啊、四大本空，五蕴非有，两鬼真是一人无可。百思不解，十方乱走，心意佛陀，正莲花解。
So,
这个意思就是说，我稍微解释， 就是说我们人都本来都是、四大都是本来都是空的，然后我们的五蕴也不是真正的、实有的。那刚才讲这个两鬼真是，就是两个鬼在那里争这个尸体。然后一人无口，就是啊，就是讲正语，他不能够说这个鬼怎么样子，他也不说水怎么样子，他就真正的说出来。但是他最重要，他还是讲起来，这个是在打坐当中，其实也没有说，所以一人无口就是讲这个离婆多。然后他后来他因为打坐这个问题出现以后，百思不解，就是一直在想这个问题，他就到处十方乱走，就是到处去乱走，然后刚好遇到佛陀，就跟他开示，他就证果，就是这样子。
你说一人无口，就说他一个人没有讲话。
对对对，他一个人不能够讲话。
Okay, so this poem tells the whole story. This praise the Master Hua wrote.Tells the whole story about Venerable Rivata. It says the four elements are, make up this body. The body is just conditioned. The five skandhas are not real. Again, the form, feeling, cognition, formation, and consciousness are not real, not self. Two ghosts fight over a body, fight over a corpse. And Venerable Rivata, he is one person but says nothing.He does not say anything at all. Because after he comes out of meditation, he's not sure if what has happened. So he wanders all around in the 10 directions, searching for an answer. Finally, he meets the Buddha and Jin-Fo, and what? The last one is Jin-Fo.
So
after he meets the Buddha, he ultimately realizes the fruit of arhatship, or here literally the lotus flower.
好，这个是上人的寄送了，他这个有印，就是念起来就是很好，就是一直有这样子的韵味。这个就是我们要学习中文的地方。
So this is a beautiful poem by Master Hua, very elegant and literary. All the tones and the sounds match.
从这个寄送，我们自己也可以回。凡尘道，我们也是不是百事不解，然后，十方乱走，就是说我们也是一样的，还在努力学习佛法当中，我们也这里听那里听这样子，我们情况也大概会跟他一样，然后也刚好我们也遇到我们非常有因缘的，能够学习佛法、学习佛陀的教法，所以他。其实我们也可以很快就可以证到阿弥陀佛国那里去。这个是我跟大家我们一起来共同鼓励的。
So we can reflect on ourselves. Are we like Venerable Bright Speech who wandered all around before he woke up looking for an answer, trying to understand if he was eaten by a ghost or not? Do we also have our own questions that we...wander around in all directions, looking there, here and there. And now that we've met the Buddha Dharma, have we gotten a good answer to answer our questions that we can follow? And ultimately, we can have the direction of being reborn in Amitabha Buddha's pure land, so that we find a place of refuge, so that we can cultivate and become Buddhas. So this is a very important Dharma that I wish to share with everyone here.
好，我们就尊者正义就讲到这里。我们后面就讲尊者大号，这个大号就是摩诃难尊者。
So, we finish Venerable Right Speech, so we get a lot of, we get to know all our various disciples from our past. So the next one is another important disciple named Venerable Great Name, Mahanama. Actually, it sounds very similar to.The names we have in English, Nama, which sounds like name, and Maha, like Mahayana, right, great vehicle. So Maha is great. So Maha, great, Nama, name, great name. Da Hao in Chinese.
Yeah. 他是佛陀的父亲净饭王的弟弟甘露王的长子。
甘露王的长子。
就是净饭王，
就是 eldest son， 就是最最最大的孩子，对不对？
对对对，
Okay, so Venerable Mahanama was actually a relative of the Buddha. It was the Buddha's father, Pure Rice King's brother, who was the eldest son of another king named Sweet Dew, or maybe it's Ambrosia. The king, or maybe Soma, probably, King Sweet Dew. So this was a relative of the Buddha. He was a relative of the Buddha.
所以他是长子，就是他又叫做居利太子。
So he was also called the Prince Ju Li. He was the eldest son. So he was kind of, you could say, a very important prince.
在唐译，就是唐朝的翻译里面，还有汉译，就是我们用汉朝方面，因为我们翻译有到从这个就是东汉一直到宋代，总共有很多翻译，所以这个译的名字啊，就是像唐译，它就是大明，汉译就是叫做大力。
So throughout the centuries in China, because of such a long time, various translations were made, the names were all slightly different, like either Da Li or Da Hao or Da Ming. Is it Ming?
Yeah, Da Ming.
Da Ming. So he had many different...
都是同样一个人。
It's all the same person, but because we have so many different names, different words we use for name, He had many different translations. It would be similar to if in English we were to translate his name as great name or great title or great epithet. You know, we were to use all these different names for him.
还有一个就是武艺，武艺就是武，就是姓名的武啊。其实我查了武艺的名的，那时候叫做摩诃那摩，就是摩诃那摩。然后这个武艺啊，就是三国时候的吴之谦，三国的时候的吴之谦。
So, he has another name called 武艺 and it comes from also Chinese history.
不是 other name 啦，他是翻译的人啦。
哦，翻译的人的名字，
嘿嘿，叫吴毅，吴志谦呐，三国时候的吴志谦。
他的名字，那翻译者。
翻译成摩诃那摩。
So, oh no, okay. So another name that was translated for him is Mohanama, which sounds very much like Mahanama,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
The Sanskrit name is Mahanama, and so this was translated by a translator.
三国
五 during the Three Kingdoms period.
魏蜀三国
Yeah, during the Three Kingdoms period, somebody named translator named Wu.
好，他也是我们五比丘最早五比丘之一，而且他又是五百罗汉里面，然后他是排名398名。
So he's also one of the first five bhikshus. And out of the 500 arhats, he's arhat number 398.
他的这个摩诃难，他在就是鹿野宴的时候，佛陀在讲四圣谛法。是制定法的时候，第三天他就得到须陀洹果。
So, 须陀洹是
第一的最初的。
So also, so he was one of the first five monks, to woke up, when after the Buddha came to teach him at Deer Park, and so for him, after he heard the Four Noble Truths, he woke up on the third day. The third day, he realized stream entry or stream.A stream enter the first stage of arhatship.
然后第五天他就证到阿罗汉果。
So on the fifth day, he realized full arhatship, four stage arhat.
所以在增阿含经里面的简山呐，他弟子品呐，这佛陀很称赞他说他非常精进，然后他速成神通。终不有悔，所以称摩诃难比丘，就是说在称赞他，努力精进修行，他很快得到神通，然后他这个精进呢，他没有什么后悔的，所以叫他是摩诃难比丘。
So in the Agama Sutras, the Buddha praises Venerable Mahanama.Saying that he is very vigorous in his cultivations. He practices and then is able to realize spiritual powers. And because of his vigor in his practice, he will have no regrets.
所以他有一天啊，他出去村庄托钵，那个村庄叫做马提加达的村庄他去托钵的时候有碰到一位叫做吉达居士吉达的人，然后他们碰到以后非常高兴，非常有缘，所以这个吉达就请他去家里供斋。
So one day Venerable Mahanama was going on alms round in a village in the area, and the village was called Machijana in Chinese transliteration of Sanskrit.And he met a layman on the road named Jida. You can maybe say he's a layman named Jida. And the way they met each other, they had a great deal of affinities. The layman liked Venerable Mahanama a great deal, and so invited him to take his meal in his house or invited him to come to receive alms at his home.
所以, 他们用斋碗以后就给, 基达基士开示, 然后这个听完以后, 这个基达, 基士非常高兴, 所以他就将他自己的, 有一块很优雅的这个灵眼呢, 就真给他, 送给真团。
So after the alms round and after eating the food, Venerable Mahanama spoke Dharma for this layman, Jida. And after hearing the Dharma, the Venerable layman was extremely happy and made an offering of a kind of forest area, like a park.
优雅的园地就是一块园地就是一个地方，一个park.
This layman made an offering of a very, you could say, a very pleasant and beautiful park to the Sangha to cultivate.
所以这个基达基士后来也在这个林园中建一座大的寺院，然后给僧团用。
So in this middle of this park, he also constructed a great monastery for the monks to practice in.
所以这个有一天就是他摩诃南尊者也给他开示，这个开示是开六次细说的一个开示，他后来他就证得。
证到阿那含果。所以有六处。六处细说，就是六次，就是六根呐。六根，七什么？细说，细说就是很详细的跟他说。哦，跟他详细跟他说。OK，阿含果，就是第三果吗？哎，三果。三果对。阿那含果。So one day, after alms round, Venerable Mahamanama also spoke Dharma again to this layman, Jida. And he spoke in detail, he explained in detail the six senses and how they function. And after hearing this Dharma talk, the layman actually realized the third stage of arhatship, an anagamin, a non-returner.
对，这个阿那含果它是不还果，就是不在
So the anagamin is one who does not need to return again into this world, or into this, you know, our existence here, before he realizes arhatship.
还有像苏果阿罗汉果，它是无邪果，无邪位了。 他是完全解脱，不用再来生死流转。
So a fourth stage arhat, often we just say arhat, they are considered those beyond study. They do not need to come back into the cycle of birth and death. They have transcended the cycle of birth and death.
那二果斯陀含果，它是叫伊莱果，最多就是再来人间。 一次就可以得到解脱。So
a second stage arhat, a second stage is what is it called? So the third stage is anagamin. Second stage is
sutohango.
Sutohan is so shrotapanna is the first stage. Second stage is sakragamin. Sakragamin is first second stage, and anagamin is a third stage, and a arhat is the fourth stage. So the first stage, we have to take seven more lives before realizing arhatship, the least amount of lives they have to go through. The second stage has 就三个，对不对？三个，还两个，一个，一个，one more, we have one more life to come back into birth and death in
对对，一来过,
this world.
哎，一来过,
and then the anagamin does not need to come back to existence here in this world. They only have to go to another, we call them the pure abode heavens. They have one place to go before they become arhats. And an arhat is beyond study, and they have transcended the cycle of birth and death.
好, 另外一个, 摩诃南他有一个经很重要，对我们修行非常重要。他就是在杂阿含经930经，阿含杂阿含里面930经里面有一篇非常重要的，我想跟大家分享这个经，非常对我们非常重要。
So there's a sutta or sutra in the Tripitaka that features Venerable Mahanama. It's an extremely important sutra, and you can find it because it's the number 930 in the Tripitaka. So I wanted to share with everyone this important sutra.
是他向佛陀请法，他那时候是在迦毗罗卫国。基尼律眼中，迦毗尼卫国就是，迦毗罗卫国就是我们佛陀的释迦子的一个地方，一个国家。
So this sutra starts with Venerable Mahanama asking the Buddha for Dharma teaching, and so this takes place in a country called Joboli Weiguo.I'm not sure. A couple of Vastu, probably. A couple of Vastu is one of the. I think that's where it is in the Sanskrit, and it's in a place where he asked the Buddha for the Dharma.
然后他问世尊，就是他跟他请法，他说：“世尊，我们现在这个国城中的人民啊，非常安乐，然后我们每次去出城去的时候，去就是到街上去的时候，很多的狂人、狂象、狂臣常常出现。这个就是说，他出去街上，他常常会碰到很多的狂，就是骑人骑着象啊，在那里跑啊跑啊这样子，他常常会出现在街道上。”
那个狂人不是发狂的意思，
就是比较兴奋那种，因为大家很快乐啊，就这样子的兴奋。
So he says, in this country, a lot of people are extremely happy. They're kind of overjoyed, and so they are a little bit kind of crazy in their happiness, and they're always riding their elephant carriages, or chariots, or whatever they're doing, kind of a little bit excited driving around, probably like people.Like young people driving their cars really fast on the street, right? It's kind of a little bit too excited, too happy.
他讲，我自恐以此诸妄计生计死。他就是说我非常的害怕恐怖啊，跟这一些在那里骑着象跑来跑去的啦，就是说随时都会。发生意外死亡，那时候啊。
This sounds just like modern times. He says, "I'm so scared going out with all these people riding their elephants in these crazy ways, riding them really fast, running into each other, and I see they crash and they could die, and so this makes me really scared." So we see this happening in modern times as well.
然后他就是说，哇，碰到这个，万一。不幸碰到死，就是被踩死了。然后那时候妄以念佛、念法、念僧，他那时候他一下子就来不及念佛、念法、念僧。
So he was worried. He said, "What happens if I get run over by these elephants? Walk all over me, and so I get killed."And I guess it's such a sudden death that I don't have time to become mindful of the Buddha, the Dharma, and the Sangha. I die very quickly. So he asked the Buddha this question. He was worried. So he asked the Buddha, saying, when I...This happens to me. If I die, what will happen to me?
然后佛告这个摩诃难说：“莫恐，莫恐，你不要恐怖，不要惊慌啊！你不要这样子， 你梦梦命中之后啊，你不会生恶气，不会生到那里去，终于没有恶，到就是你不会再生到那里。这恶恶就是三恶道，这个就是说第一恶鬼出生，你不会生到那里去。
So the Buddha's response to Venerable Mahanama, he said, Mahanama, do not be afraid, have no fear. When if you die in this kind of way, in this kind of like you say accident, or this kind of sudden way, you will not fall into the paths of suffering. That we often say the lower paths, like the hells, the hungry ghosts and animals, you won't fall into those places of suffering.
这个就是啊，比如啊，这个佛陀在跟他开示，比如大树，一棵大树，顺下顺住顺疏。若在根本当堕何处，就是他也顺便在问他说，像一棵大树，他就是有一点偏在哪里哪一边，然后他倒下来的时候，就是说你把它砍的时候，他倒下来的时候会倒在哪一边，这是顺便在问他，就是说大树倒本来就歪一边，然后你要倒在哪一边，
这个是那个他还问佛陀，佛陀的回答。
对佛陀的回答，然后回答又反问他。
Oh, so okay, got it. So the Buddha likes to ask questions back. So the Buddha gave Venerable Mahanama a question. He said, "A big tree that leans to the side. When it comes time for it to fall over, suddenly, which direction does it fall?"
然后他就跟他跟他说，他会顺着这个，因为他偏这边，他就顺着那边倒，就会往那边去倒。那佛陀就说，哦，这个就是这样子。
So, Venerable Mahanama, very smart, and he responded back saying, "The tree will fall in the direction it is leaning. The way it's leaning, that's the direction it will fall." And so the Buddha said, "Yeah, that's the way it is."
然后就是说，所以这样佛陀又讲说，你命中的时候你不会生恶气，就是不会生到三恶道去。所以为什么呢？他佛陀就解释了。
So the Buddha said, "So this is just like the question you just asked. When it's time for you to die, and if it's done in such a sudden way." You won't fall into the three paths of suffering. Why is this? Now the Buddha will explain.
然后就是说，因为你长夜休息念佛、念法、念真，若命中时，此生若就是说，因为你常常在心修这个念佛、念法、念真，因为就是说我们平常都要念就对了，念法、念真、念。佛念法念真，所以因为你这样子常常在心修，所以你命中的时候，假如说你命中就说你死了以后，这个身体像被火，他又继续在解释，你身体假如说你死了以后，你被火烧，就是拿去火葬或是去烧成骨灰了。或者是你背的尸体在肉气丛间，就是好像你的身体被丢弃在坟墓旁边，然后日风飘日晒，就是你的尸体在那里风飘日晒，九成沉默，就是说变成后面也变成灰尘了而你的心事久远。长夜正信所心，会不会太长？
最后你是什么？
哈？
什么？你的说你的心是什么？
你的心意识就是你的心，然后你的意，然后你的八识，
都是清净的。
不是久，因为你久远长夜正信所心，就是说你
就
是在。常常就是在心修这些佛法僧，因为你是正念的正信的，所以常常心修，所以还有你的 思戒思文慧守心，就是说你常常守戒啊，然后布施啊，这闻佛法听法，然后你的这些戒定慧啊，因为你在心修，所以你神识上升会去到安乐的地方，你将来就是会升天。当然像我们念佛人，就是说我们念佛会升到阿弥陀佛的地方。
So the story goes, so the Buddha gives an analogy saying that so because you constantly are mindful of the Buddha, mindful of the Dharma, mindful of the Sangha, then you already have created that practice, that leaning in your mind. In your mind, you have this leaning towards the Buddha, the Dharma, and Sangha. So when it's time for you to go, even though it might be sudden, you will still, even when you after you die, and your spirit, you will have that leaning, and you will remember and go towards a wholesome destination. You won't fall into an evil destiny. It's like a rebirth that's suffering. And so you won't, if, like your body gets cremated, or for instance, your body is left next to the grave site and is decaying in the sun and falls apart and becomes dust. Still, your mind is mindful of the Buddha, mindful of the Dharma, mindful of the Sangha. And it's been trained because you hold the precepts, constantly learn and study and listen to the Dharma. And you practice the three non-outflow practices of precepts, samadhi, and wisdom. So when you die, you will for sure go to a happy rebirth, most likely to the heavens. So this is similar to us who are reciting the Buddha's name, reciting Amitabha Buddha. So we constantly recite Amitabha Buddha, and when it's time for us to go, then our mind leans towards the Pure Land, so then we can go to the Pure Land.
所以这个是给我们很好的信息，也很重要的信息。因为我们平常都有大家来这边共修，回去也不要忘记念佛、念法、念真，这个就是非常重要的。就是说，我们在家居士在外面，像开车啊，去哪里，这个都随时都，有时候我们不小心了怎样子，我们小心，别人不小心，就会造成不幸发生。所以这个也不用怕。我们就是给我们一个这个一个保证，所以这个法就是给我们一个保证，即使发生了这个事情也没有关系，不要惊慌。我们因为到时候神识，你既然发生那个时候没有办法念，但是你后面的神识它都会回来了，都会回去，回去以后就是一样的，在法中就是你念佛，你就是会回到阿弥陀佛那里去，这样子一个，所以我觉得是给我们很大的一个好的一个重要的保证消息。
So you can say this is very good teaching for us Pure Land practitioners. It's almost like a guarantee that we come here together and we recite the Buddha's name and we practice and we cultivate. And so one thing we should do if we're lay people, that would be very helpful, is that wherever we go, if we're on the car, we're driving, we're going through our daily activities, we should continue to be mindful of the Buddha, practice Buddha recitation, and be mindful of the Dharma and the Sangha as well. And so, for instance, if we're driving and we're not careful in our driving and an accident happens, or we're careful, perhaps we're always careful, but you can't always be sure that other people are not careful. And so something might still happen, and we might get in a car accident and have, for instance, like a sudden death. And however, this teaching that the Buddha gives us a almost like a guarantee, kind of to give us like a safety, saying that although at that moment when you're dying, you die, you might not remember to recite the Buddha's name. But after that, after you die, you'll regain your what's going on again, your brain kind of an awareness, and then you'll continue to recite the Buddha's name. And because you continue to recite, then you can go to the Pure Land. So for us who are Buddha recitation practitioners, who are mindful of the Buddha as much as we can, then this is a very important teaching, giving us faith and confidence that even if we die suddenly, regardless of the situation, we do not have to have any fear. We will naturally go to the Pure Land.
好，摩诃难，我想还再解释一个，就是他这个摩诃难的名词，因为这个很多的经典呢、啊，就他有讲到一个发生过释迦族不是被啊、被那个琉璃王消灭嘛，灭亡嘛，那时候摩诃难。他就是把自己的头发绑在火里边底下，不给他浮起来。像这个手伸，他为这个人民舍掉的生命，听就是看经典是同一个人，所以有这样子一个事情。因为故事啊、我们在这里没有时间讲，所以我们不讲，我只是提一下这样子，是同，好像是应该是同一个人。
说头发。
把头发绑在那个河底底下石头，不要给他浮起来。在他为了要救那个啊释迦族的人逃命啊，你这个故事、
哦、
你知道吗？
没听过，没听过。I think there's a story where I think people know that the Shakya clan, the Buddha's clan, actually got I don't even call it genocide, kind of got completely wiped out by another king.There's a king, I think his name was Liu Li Wang. I forgot who he is in Sanskrit. But anyways, he actually wiped out the entire Shakya clan. And Venerable Mahanama actually there's a very famous story where he tried to use his hair?
Yeah, 要救，因为要救,
to save the Shakya clan.
那些人民哈，就是说希望他在河里面还没浮起来以前啊，不要杀那些人，给他们逃出去城外。所以那个琉璃王答应了，然后他就跳在河里面，然后就把头，他不要给他浮起来，他就把头发绑在石头上，不给他浮起来。
他自己浮起来，不给他自己
浮起来。不给他浮起来。
他自己身体。
他对他身，他是等于为那些人逃命的人牺牲了。
So he, in order to save the clan, he told a venerable, the king who wanted to go murder the whole Shakya clan, and he told him, would you please not kill them all? If I go into the river and I do not come up, my body does not come up, will you not go and kill the clan? And so he jumped into the river, and he tied his hair onto the rocks.On the bottom of the river, so that he wouldn't come back up, and so he sacrificed himself for the clan.
那个刘帝王看了那么久都没有起来，他叫人家下去查。哦，原来他是把头发绑在石头上。
So
他也死了，就对了。
So the king, Liu Li Wang, he was waiting a long time for the body to start come up again. He couldn't find it, and so.He asked somebody to go down and take a look, and they saw that he had tied himself to his hair to the rocks underneath, and so that's how he died. And so, so that's his story.
Okay, 我们时间也差不多九点多，我们
所
以后面请静和师。
So we have something for Jin Ho Shr to share with everyone.Okay.
Oh.
So, it's okay. So, okay. So, we will end the sutra lecture now, and we won't be having the next part online.
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so we'll do our transference of merit now.It should be on the back of your requesting Dharma sheet. I don't know if people have it. I see the women's side doesn't have the requesting Dharma sheet. It's the yellow sheet. It looks like this. If people don't have it, maybe somebody can help pass it out. Maybe Pedro. I see the women's side. The men's side all have it. Or Alice can find it. And the requesting or the transference of merit is in the back.We have Alan over here to give us the musical background. which is nice. When River Heng Sure is away, we have to do teamwork so that we can do the transference of merit. So today, if you can think of all the goodness that we did today, reciting the Buddha's name, doing a memorial service, and coming to sutra lecture, and listening to the Dharma, there's a lot of goodness that we can transfer and give away. So now is the time that we can make a sincere wish in our hearts and send it off wherever we like. And the sound and the music helps facilitate that process.
Okay.
Slideshow for the rest of the evening. Also, we have actually Buddha recitation tomorrow, one day Buddha recitation on our first Sundays here at Berkeley Monastery. So people who would like to join can come. We start around 7:30 and we go all the way to about 5 o'clock. So if people are interested in spending a day reciting the Buddha's name, please join us. Otherwise, we have a Guanyin session coming up in 2 weeks at the City of 10,000 Buddhas starting October 15th. And we also have Buddhism for the Modern Mind this Monday with Doug Powers. So with a lot of Dharma activities for those who are interested.